We'll discuss about genetic disorders. A genetic disorder is a disease or syndrome that is caused by an abnormality in an individual DNA. Okay, so when anything goes wrong with the DNA, it causes genetic disorder. Okay, and it is sometimes called a syndrome also, because a disease is treatable and syndrome is untreatable. Okay, it cannot be treated easily medically or by doctors. So it is in that case it is called syndrome, but diseases are usually treatable, okay, and curable. Okay, so abnormalities can range from a small mutation. So abnormalities in gene or DNA, it can range from a small mutation in a single gene to the addition or subtraction of an entire chromosome or even a set of chromosomes. So the mutation or abnormalities that are caused in the DNA may be very small mutation in a single gene, or it may be major changes or major mutation that is due to addition or subtraction of an entire chromosome or even a set of chromosomes. Genetic disorders are of two types, namely Mendelian disorders and chromosomal disorders. We'll discuss about now Mendelian disorders. So alteration or mutation in a single gene causes Mendelian disorder. Okay, so when a mutation, it occurs in a single gene, or changes occur in a single gene, that causes Mendelian disorders. These disorders are transmitted to the offsprings on the same line as the Mendelian pattern of inheritance. Okay, the transmission or the inheritance of these disorders follows Mendelian pattern of inheritance. Okay, so some examples for Mendelian disorders are thalassemia, albinism, phenylketonuria, sickle cell anemia, Huntington's chorea, etc. These disorders may be dominant or recessive and autosomal or sex-linked. We'll discuss now about what is thalassemia. And thalassemia is an autosomal recessive disorder. It is caused by gene mutation resulting in excessive destruction of RBCs. Okay, excessive destruction of RBCs is the symptom of this disease, thalassemia, and it is caused by gene mutation. So, due to this, what happens is abnormal hemoglobin molecules are formed due to gene mutation that results in excessive destruction of RBCs. It is because of formation of abnormal hemoglobin molecules. Normally, hemoglobin is composed of four polypeptide chains, two alpha globin chains and two beta globin chains. So, hemoglobin molecule is composed of four polypeptide chains, two alpha and two beta globin chains. Thalassemia patients have defects in either the alpha or beta globin chain, causing the production of abnormal hemoglobin molecules, resulting in anemia. So due to destruction of RBCs, and it is because of the formation of the abnormal hemoglobin molecules, it results in anemia. And thalassemia is classified into alpha and beta based on which chain of hemoglobin molecule is affected. Okay, based on the chain of hemoglobin molecule, okay, the type of chain of hemoglobin molecule is affected, so that based on that it is classified. Thalassemia is classified depending on whether alpha globin chain or beta globin chain is affected. So based on it, it is classified. So this alpha thalassemia, it is controlled by two closely linked genes, HBA1 and HBA2 on chromosome 16. Okay, that is, this alpha thalassemia, it is caused by two closely linked genes, HBA1 and HBA2, which are located on chromosome 16. So mutation or deletion of one or more of the four alpha gene alleles causes alpha thalassemia. So the reason for alpha thalassemia is mutation or deletion of one or more of the four alpha gene alleles that causes alpha thalassemia. In beta thalassemia, production of beta globin chain is affected. Okay, remember, in alpha thalassemia, that alpha globin chain is affected. In beta thalassemia, beta globin chain is affected. Formation of this beta globin chain, it is depending on a single gene, or it is controlled by a single gene, HBB, which is present on chromosome 11. It is the most common type of thalassemia. Beta thalassemia is the most common type of thalassemia, and it is also known as Coolie's anemia. In this disorder, the alpha chain production is increased and damages the membranes of RBC. So in this disorder, that is alpha thalassemia, the alpha chain production is increased and damages the membranes of RBC. And this is about phenylketonuria, another disorder, and it is an inborn error of phenylalanine metabolism caused due to a pair of autosomal recessive genes. Okay, this is also a Mendelian disorder, or it is caused due to mutation in a single gene, and it is caused due to mutation in the gene PAH, that is phenylalanine hydroxylase gene, located on chromosome 12. So this gene PAH, it is responsible for the production of this enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. So this phenylalanine hydroxylase, it is useful in the conversion of phenylalanine into tyrosine. Phenylalanine is an amino acid, even tyrosine is an amino acid. So the conversion of phenylalanine to tyrosine takes place in the presence of phenylalanine hydroxylase, which is an enzyme. And for the production of this enzyme, the gene is very important, a particular gene. So when this gene, this phenylalanine hydroxylase gene, which is responsible for the production of this enzyme, when it undergoes mutation, this enzyme cannot be produced. So what happens is, as a result of it, more phenylalanine is accumulated. Okay, this enzyme is essential for the conversion of phenylalanine to tyrosine. So affected individuals do not have this enzyme because of the mutation of this gene, which is responsible for this enzyme. So what happens is, phenylalanine gets accumulated and gets converted into phenylpyruvic acid and other derivatives. It is characterized by severe mental retardation. Due to this, the symptoms are the severe mental retardation, light pigmentation of skin and hair. Phenylpyruvic acid is excreted in the urine, and this is the reaction to show the conversion of phenylalanine into tyrosine in the presence of phenylalanine hydroxylase. So this is albinism. It is an inborn error of metabolism caused due to an autosomal recessive gene. Melanin pigment is responsible for skin color. Okay, all of us have melanin pigment that gives us color to the skin. So absence of melanin, it results in the condition called albinism. So there will be very less pigmentation. So people look very pale and fair also. So a person with the recessive allele lacks the tyrosinase enzyme system, which is required for the conversion of dihydroxyphenylalanine, DOPA, dihydroxyphenylalanine, into melanin pigment inside the melanocytes. So melanocytes are the cells which contain melanin pigment. So melanocytes will be present. So in albinos or people who are affected with albinism, they have melanocytes, but they will be in normal number also, but melanin pigment is absent. So these melanocytes are present in normal numbers, usually in human beings, on their skin, hair, iris, etc. But these affected individuals, they have melanocytes, but they don't have melanin pigment. So this is 3,4-dihydroxyphenylalanine. That is converted into melanin in the presence of tyrosinase. Okay, so a person with the recessive allele lacks tyrosinase enzyme. So due to that, people are affected. So this melanin pigments will be absent. So that results in albinism. Okay, and this is the last one, Huntington's chorea, and it is characterized by involuntary jerking of the body and progressive degeneration of the nervous system, accompanied by gradual mental and physical deterioration. The patients with this disease usually die between the age of 35 and 40. This is also an autosomal dominant lethal gene in man. Why it is called lethal gene in man means it is resulting in death of the individuals between the age of 35 and 40. Okay, thank you.